Hello, and thank you for joining us today. This is another back-to-back PR interviews. We're excited at our guests that are coming on the show. My name is Carol Crawford, and I'm the CEO of Back-to-Back PR. You can connect with me through my website, on Instagram, on Facebook. Just look up Back-to-Back PR and I'll be there. All right, enjoy this interview. Everyone watching, thank you for tuning in. My name is Carol Crawford of Back to Back PR, and today my guests are living legends in the music industry. They've been together for 50 years now and have produced some wonderful, amazing, and powerful music. So help me to welcome my guests today. Sounds of Blackness. Help me to welcome my guests today. Welcome, Sounds of Blackness. Hello, hello. Hi, everyone. Good to see you. It is so good to see you. Welcome. Hi, Gary.
And hey, Carol, thank you so much.
Sounds of Blackness. They're in studio right now. They've just given us some time to talk to us today, and we appreciate you for that. Thank you.
Thank you for having us, Carol.
Well, listen, I want to start by congratulating you on 50 years. What an achievement. What an accomplishment. How exciting. Congratulations. Yes, 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 yes. And you know what? You've written some inspiring and prolific songs over the years. And I'd like to know, can you share with us, what is your creative process when you're writing these songs? What is your creative process like?
Well, the creative process is to be, first of all, God-inspired and event-inspired. For example, when we wrote Sick and Tired for George Floyd, that was an event that shocked and moved the entire world. And Sounds of Blackness knew that we had to put music to it. So by the inspiration of God and by the circumstances of our life around us.
Wonderful, wonderful. Thank you. And you know, your music speaks to so many situations, so many circumstances. And we just appreciate you for the quality of music and the words that you're putting out today. Thank you so much for that. And you know, you've been on stage with so many great artists over the years. Who would you like to collaborate with now and why?
Well, let me throw that. Carrie, who would you like us to collaborate with now?
For me, the most, I'd have to say Beyonce.
Okay, you better be able to dance.
Oh, well, Carrie is our choreographer, so she can handle that.
Okay, Carrie. Mary. All right, you got it. Well, let's see. Hopefully, in the months to come, that will be a reality. That would be awesome. That would be awesome. So, you know, what would you be doing right now if it was not for your music career? What would you be doing if you were not singing and you were not part of Sounds of Blackness?
Reggie, why don't you tell us about that?
Well, I probably still would be doing what I'm doing now. I act outside of Sounds of Blackness, and I am in the nursing field as well. So I'll still be doing that if I wasn't a part of Sounds. But but I am glad that I am a part of Sounds, because it helps me just to live my life every day, inspired and making sure that I'm making a change every day.
Wonderful. We're glad too. And thank you for serving us as a nurse or in the nursing field. We know this has not been an easy time for any medical staff. So we just want to thank you for whatever you're doing in that arena. Yes. Yes. And how has this year impacted you all, the past 2 years now? How has it impacted you, whether it's positively or negatively? Has there been an impact during this season of uncertainty and change?
Oh, absolutely. Bridget, why don't you weigh in on that?
Well, I will say it has impacted me mostly positively, because I feel that we're in a time that we have to really be concerned about each other and about what's going on in the world, and even to be a little bit more forward with the things that we do in our lives every day. So I think it brings a consciousness to me that I had before, but it's a little bit more elevated and heightened now.
Right.
So I deem it has, it's been more favorable than negative. Of course, we've all had negative, things happen, and we've lost people. Mm-hmm. I actually lost my father during this time.
So it
definitely has impacted me in a way that, that will be with me for a long time.
Yes, yes. Yes, thanks for sharing that, and our condolences and prayers to you. Yeah,
thank
it's been
you.
such a tough time for a lot of people, a lot of families. So we can pray for you now. We can lift you up, ask God to keep giving you strength, to comfort you, to set His angels around you, and just remember those great memories.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for sharing that. You know, during this pandemic, during these past couple of years, has anyone, done a new hobby, or have you done anything like completely different to what you're doing now?
I know.
Oh.
Melody.
Hi, I'm Melody.
Hi.
My middle name is Carol, by the way.
Awesome. Tell me, are you a Christmas baby? I was born near Christmas, so Christmas Carol.
It was after my grandma. But at any rate, I actually started doing visual art and painting, and I completed my first mural. So that was pretty big for me.
Wonderful. That's awesome. Now, did you know you could paint, or is it something that you kind of having that time for, or you just discovered during this season?
I knew I could paint. I'm a self-taught artist. I probably started in 2007, and I didn't know that it would come that much to the forefront of my life. Sounds of Blackness has really helped me with my self-esteem and to be able to step into the light of what I believe God is asking me to do and allow Him to flow through me. And that's exactly what happened when I was proposed to do the mural. It was from a previous employer of mine. Mm-hmm. And, my friends are like, ask for half of it up front. And I had never done a mural before, but I stepped forward and I said, yes, I can do that. And I would be honored. And so that's exactly what happened.
That is awesome. And we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us.
Right. That's right.
Yes. Wonderful. Wonderful. And I can see 50 years along the front of your sweaters. I'd like to hear some, just some things that you recall over the 50 years, some memories, some things that were surprising to you, or just, you know, funny? You know, you must have had a lot of different experiences. You've been to so many places. What can you recall over the 50 years? Share some things with us.
Well, there's a lot, Carol, and I should clarify very quickly. Yours truly here is the only one that's been here all 50 years.
Oh, Gary!
Most of these people were not even born yet. But the interesting thing is that this is really Sounds of Blackness second generation for the most part. We have a number of these people, actually their parents were original members, so they're offspring. So this is second generation Sounds of Blackness, but they still have stories to tell. So Ayana is a veteran member. Tell us something you remember, Soul Train or whatever you want.
Yeah. Meeting Harry Belafonte.
Yeah. Oh.
That was probably one of the biggest experiences for me because it was someone that I loved to see on TV as a child.
Yeah.
And then to have the ability to meet him face to face, that was like one of the biggest experiences for me in Sounds.
Wonderful, wonderful. A legend in his own right. That's awesome. Yes. Awesome. So Gary's the one that's been there from the beginning. Gary, talk to us about the beginning. How, what, when? Just, you know, share with us about the beginnings of Sounds of Blackness.
Certainly, Carol. Just about 3 miles from where we are now, and we're at High School for Recording Arts, which we love, our new home. But 3 miles from here is McAllister College, my alma mater. Mm-hmm. And in 1969, this predominantly white institution embarked on a very ambitious program called EEO, which stands for Expanded Educational Opportunities. Mm-hmm. And one of the offsets of that, they had almost 100 Black students on campus at one time. And one of the results of that is that the students themselves organized a number of different activities. There was a political group called BLAC, which still exists. That stands for Black Liberation Affairs Committee. There was a theater group called Black Arts Midwest, and there was this 50-voice choir started by our emeritus founder, Mr. Russell Knighton, called the McAllister College Black Voices. And in 1971, my sophomore year, Russell was getting ready to graduate, and he asked me on as director. And my goal with the group, the vision really that God gave me, was to continue the tradition of Duke Ellington. Now, that surprises a lot of people when I say that.
Wow.
Because we hear Duke Ellington's name, and we think of jazz, and we should. But too many people don't know that Duke wrote, recorded, and performed jazz, spirituals, blues, gospel, African music, every sound of Blackness. And so that's where we got the repertoire idea from. And so we needed to change our name to fit the fact that we would be singing every sound of Blackness. So that's like the history and the meaning of the name.
That is amazing. And I didn't know that. I associate Duke Ellington with jazz, but this is great. Great education for us. Great education. So look, I'm so excited because you, the Sounds of Blackness, are nominated for an NAACP Image Award in the category Outstanding Gospel Christian Song. And we want everyone that is watching us to go online and vote. You can either do it through soundofblackness.org's website, or you can go to NAACP Image Awards and you'll see those links in the chat. So please click that link and vote the Outstanding Gospel Christian Song. We want them to win. So tell us, talk to us about your single, your Time for Reparation single, and also, you know, how are you feeling right now? You're nominated and oh my goodness, how are you feeling?
We're excited.
Yeah.
You know, we're elated and excited, you know, but we're also humbled by this. And it's a real validation, Carol, of not only what Sounds of Blackness does, but for radio, it was, they thought an aberration for Sounds of Blackness to do a song like last year, Sick and Tired, and now Time for Reparation, because radio is used to optimistic. And I believe in all those positive songs. But really, our roots, going back to McAllister College that we talked about a moment ago, are in protest music. So it's a return to our roots. And we're so glad that the NAACP endorsed and validated that now with Time for Reparations.
Wonderful, wonderful. Now, time for reparations. It's got really some deep meanings, real deep meanings for a lot of us. Can you talk to us about that? How did that really come about? Why now? Why time for reparations?
Well, I'll say this, and then I'm going to ask some more of the members to weigh in as well. But it's important to realize that the movement for reparations is not at all new. It goes back to, in fact, it actually precedes the 1860s. But what's happened now, this is the current manifestation, Carol, yes. of the movement. And yes. every movement of our people around the world, the struggle for justice and equality, has always had an anthem to it. So right. the civil rights movement had, "We Shall
Overcome."
The Black Power and Black is Beautiful movement had, "Say It Loud."
I'm Black and I'm Proud.
And so, we can't call ourselves Sounds of Blackness when time for reparations comes up. The Congressional Black Caucus introduced H.R. 40 into Congress for reparations. So it's already underway. It's not something that's just imaginary. And we needed to supply it, the movement, with an anthem. And this group of people right here are the voices that you hear. Lacey came in and did some special vocal overlays with us kind of thing. Two of our members in Kansas City, Yolanda and Andrea, did the lead work. But Lacey, tell us about when you came in to do those extra vocals.
Okay. Well, you know, I really want to speak about the meaning you asked, you know, why now, why time for reparations? Mm-hmm. And one of the things, of course, all the racial injustice has been unfortunately brought back to the forefront, sparked by, you know, the George Floyd situation. And so, with that being said, a lot of folks, non-people of color, they're asking, why are you talking about reparations? What is this? So one of the things I like about the song is it is the perfect description of why we're asking for reparations. If you had any question, you ever didn't know why we should be paid reparations, just pop on the song and it gives you hundreds of examples of the things that have been done to our people historically. And it also, you know, when people think about racism, they relate it back to years and years ago, but it's something that is very prevalent today.
Yes.
And so the song Reparations takes the fact that people are trying to water that down. And so that brings the message back to the forefront. So when I was asked to put my voice on the song and to, as Gary said, it just needed a little extra something. So I felt blessed to be able to give it that push that it needed and just, highlight the importance of, you know, the time that it is time for a song like that.
That's great. Thank you. Thanks for that. We need to highlight a song like that because this is something that's impacted every person of color's life over the years. I saw the video. It's amazing. It's amazing. And you know, in the UK, we have the same thing going on. So this should be an anthem for every country that's dealing with this particular subject. Keep it at the forefront. Let's talk about it. Let's make it right. At least make it right. But thank you. Thank you for time for reparations. And if you haven't heard it, and if you haven't purchased it, because we support by purchasing, go and download from your favorite download store. Time for reparations, Sounds of Blackness. I'm excited about it and I can't wait until next month because we are going to be praying that Image NAACP Image Award through. You deserve it. You've put in the work and thank you for keeping this subject, this topic that's important to all of us to the forefront. So listen, I just want to know what is the best advice that you've been given over the years? What is the best advice that you've been given over the years? And it can be to do with music, it can be to do with life, but what is the best advice you've been given?
Well, I'll say a quick one and then open it up for whoever else wants to weigh in. We were blessed to know and to work with the late, great Maya Angelou. And she said so many prolific things, as we all know.
Yeah.
But one of the things she said to us, and in fact, she brought Sounds of Blackness on when she made her directorial film debut and had us do a song for that. And so we did a song called Don't Let Nothing Keep You Down. And I'll never forget, she gave us the advice and she said this, When you know better, do better. Simple, poignant, to the point.
Yes. Anybody when you know better, do better.
Smokey?
I do. From my esteemed director, practice, okay. Be dedicated and consistent in all that you do, especially when it comes to the sounds of blackness. We get messages daily, practice. And recognizing how significant and how important that is, and the development that is able to be recognized if you continue to do that. The dedication, as the example of Gary Hines is, 50 years will get you into a place where you will be recognized and people will acknowledge what you have. Truly a gifted and amazing man to me, and I'm honored to be with these people, and Gary Hines is the director. So this has been true blessing.
Wonderful. Thank you.
To piggyback on Smokey, in those daily messages, it's pray, practice, perspire. So mind, body, and soul is the
file. Say that again. Pray.
Pray, practice, perspire.
Yeah. Love it. I love it. And for those that are just now tuning in to watch us, we are talking, I'm talking to Gary Hines and Sounds of Blackness. And guess what? They have been nominated for an NAACP Image Award for Outstanding Gospel / Christian Song. So we're going to get behind them, we're going to support them, and we're going to go to their website and we are going to vote. We are going to vote that NAACP Image Award in. Oh my goodness, it's been so good talking to you. Now listen, what word of advice or encouragement would you like to give to those that are watching us? What word of advice or encouragement would you like to give to those that are watching us?
I would say, to piggyback on Lacey, to that we want everybody, you know, to pray, and to persevere, some different P's, some prayer and perseverance, persistence.
Yes.
And the same kind of consistency, Smokey, back there, Steve was talking about, the ultimate measure of excellence is consistency. Anybody can be good for a day, but consistency through that prayer life, through the preparation, you gotta sweat. There's sweat equity that goes, my old football coach used to say, there's a price to be paid. And that applies to music and to life as well. And these people pay the price. They are talented professionals. They have other professions in their life, but they're full-time also musicians, singers, songwriters, artists in their own right. And so we would encourage everybody in terms of your direction to follow that lead.
Wonderful, wonderful. Thank you for that. Thank you. And so we can't have you on here without, you know, hearing a little something. So we'd love to hear just something live right there in studio. Over to you.
All right. Everybody, a little bit of hold on, change this camera. Okay. Ooh, ooh, ooh. 1, 2, 3.
Da, 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 da. Hold on. Change is coming. Hold on. Don't worry about a thing. Hold on. You can make it. Hold on. Everything will be all right. Hold on.
Oh my word. That was awesome. I feel like I'm in the studio with you. Oh, that was so nice. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. And you know, I'm just thinking about the words that you shared. If you know better, do better, pray, practice, persevere. Those are some good words that we can hold on to. And I'd love to give you, Gary, just the final say, the final words to our viewers, to those that are watching us. I'd love you to just talk to them, whatever's on your heart.
Absolutely. On behalf of Sounds of Blackness, this beautiful aggregation of brothers and sisters, our singers, and in their absence, our shout out to our band as well.
Yes.
We want to take this opportunity to thank you. Thank you, Carol. Thank all of you listeners, followers, everybody, for your support of Sounds of Blackness, however long it's been. It probably hasn't been the whole 50 years. If it's been 50 minutes, thank you for your support of Sounds of Blackness. That's the biggest thing. We don't get an opportunity enough to say thank you. We can make all the music we want, but without, you know, the Bible says, how will they hear without a preacher? Well, how will they hear the music without a DJ, without a carol, without a station? And so what would it mean if it didn't, what comes from the heart reaches the heart, didn't reach your hearts? So this is our opportunity on behalf of this beautiful group of women and men to say thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. And I just want to say on behalf of everyone watching that we love you. We appreciate you. You've impacted our lives in so many ways, so many positive ways. When we feel down and we put your music on, it makes us dance. It uplifts us. It encourages us and it causes us to think. So thank you for your tireless efforts. 50 years from the parents to the kids, the next generation. It's amazing. What a legacy that you are bringing on for your children, your grandchildren. We appreciate you. Thank you so much. Sounds of Blackness.
Thank you.
God bless you.